Hello, we are the Jerome family, and we have been members at St. Paul's for 14 years. I'm Cece. This is Abby, Emmy, Liam, and Russ.
Romans chapter 12, verse 5. So we who are many are one body in Christ, and individually we are members one of another.
So maybe before I get started, Cece said we've been here 14 years, not quite 140 years like Ron Zelli has been. So we're trying to bookend this just a little bit. So in 2008, we moved here as a young family. Abby was 8 months pregnant. Cecilia wasn't quite two. And one of the first things we wanted to do was start looking for a place of faith. We wanted to find a church home because we knew that it would help us find friends and a good community to be a part of. 14 years later, our kids have been able to build a solid faith foundation by attending preschool and kindergarten through sixth grade at St. Paul's School. They've been involved in Sunday school, Saints Alive, VBS, confirmation, and are continuing on with high school youth group. We feel very fortunate that they have adults and mentors here who care for them and pray for them and encourage them.
Being members at St. Paul's helped us as adults develop friendships with others as well. These friendships have led to 7 Boundary Waters trips, and counting, involvement in volleyball and softball leagues, many fun times making a monthly lunch for the St. Paul's school kids, and numerous get-togethers. For Russell and I, the missions of St. Paul's have given us a way to know, engage with, and help in our community, all of which are important for us to model to our kids. As our family became more engaged and involved at St. Paul's, we became more and more appreciative of belonging to a congregation that had local and global mission, a welcoming environment, and a solid foundation in the Christian faith. This bedrock that St. Paul's is built on has been and will be consistent, but we know the tools to carry out our mission and share our faith need to change to engage and excite new generations in their own faith journeys and mission. We're grateful for the commitment St. Paul's members have made in the past for us to continue the work they started. We hope you will prayerfully join us in turning in your pledge card to help create an environment that future generations of St. Paul's families and the Waverly community can use to build their faith and continue our collective mission.
Ephesians 4:11 through 13. The gifts he gave were that some would be apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors and teachers, to equip the saints for the work of ministry, for building up the body of Christ until all of us come to the unity of the faith and of the faith knowledge of the Son of God, to maturity, to the measure of all the full stature of Christ.
Thank you.